Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lecture, which will be on model forms, and we're specifically going to use the create and the read functionality out of CRUD. Okay, so just to summarize what we did in the last lesson, we created like a route here, which is called create task. And as you can see here, we have our Django model form here that takes in a title and it takes in content. Okay, so now we're actually going to make this functional and actually create a task. But before we do that, I just want to quickly run through what we did before. So in our to-do app here, in models.py, we created a model in the previous lectures ago, a long time ago, that specifically takes all the fields, but we focusing, of course, only on the title and the content attribute. Then we created a Django model form that takes in all these fields. Then, of course, we went to our views.py file. We imported our form here, which is called task form. And here under this view here, we are creating our task. And we're rendering, of course, our, let's see where it is, our task form here. We're rendering this out. So you can see the following result here that we have is rendering our task form out. Okay, so this was the template that we used for task form. Okay, as you can see here, there's no functionality here to actually create a record, but this has given us a good start to now go ahead and make this actually functional. All right, so let's get started and do just that. So let's create a record, all right? So first thing that we want to do is we just want to edit this just a little bit. So what we can do is we can simply leave our task form here. So I just want to rename this here. I want to call this create task. Okay, so that is a little bit cleaner. So we understand what this is because we're creating a task. So I want to go here and I want to just change the HTML here to create task. Okay, perfect. There we go. Okay, so we have our create task form and we have our views here. So all we need to do to make this functional is we just need to simply change our views here. Our template is perfectly fine. We just need to adjust our views here. So let's have a look what we need to do. So first of all, I just want to take out the context for now and here the context dictionary, and I just want to leave it here. Okay, so the first thing that we're doing is we want to, of course, call our form. So we're setting it, the variable here, form, and setting it to our task form. So we're going to carry over those attributes, title and content, in this variable. Okay, the next thing we need to do, we want to check if when we send this, submit this HTML form, okay, that it is indeed a post request. And we need to do some sort of backend validation here just to check if it is indeed a post request. And if it is, we can carry on proceeding with what we need to do. So to do, the next step would be to say if request.message equals post. So you need double equals here to test for equivalency. And then if it's equal to post, we want to set our form here to our task form again. And we need to pass in request.post because this is what we want to do with our task form. We actually want to submit a post request. So we're just saying, okay, I want to submit a post request with this data in task form. So with these attributes then, just to make sure that we don't have, for example, errors in our form or anything, we need to check if the form is actually valid. So we would say if form.is_valid. Okay, if it is, then we're going to say form.save. Okay, so remember we set form equal to task form. So if you see it here being referenced, we're referring to this here. So all the contents being posted in our form, if it's valid, we want to save. So the way that I treat this .save method is to kind of treat it like a post request. So like saying form.create, form.post. So try and think of it that way. So this is basically going to send our data to the database once we submit a post request. Okay, and if that was done correctly, I want to say return redirect. Let's say redirect. Okay, and for now, I probably don't have a redirect here. Let's see. Ah, so we can just simply add here. So append to our shortcuts here and import redirect. So we can say here return redirect. And there we go. Okay, so for now, I'm just going to say return. Let's see if we can. Yeah, we can say HTTP response for now. So I'm just going to say your task was created. Okay, there we go. So I just want us to see everything clear here. So I just want to go ahead to our admin page for now. And I want to delete all the objects that we currently have. So let's go to our tasks. And we have three here. I want to delete all of these for now. Okay, you can go and log out. Okay, so I just want to go back to the admin page here, just like that. So just leave it like this. And what we want to do is we just want to delete all of this here by our homepage. Okay, we can delete that and delete the context. So all we're doing is we're rendering out a simple index.html page. So as we can see here in index.html, we need to also take this away. So this will be invalid. So we just want to see it say this is our homepage. So we're just cleaning a little bit here. So once we go back to our homepage, okay, we'll just see this, okay, which is perfectly fine. So we just wanted to clean that up. All right. Okay, so we'll be able now to create our task. So what we're going to do is go ahead and test this out. So remember this URL. So the URL here for create task is here. So we can simply just go to that there. So we can say create task. Okay, and what we need to do is we need to go back to our create task.html. And then we need to go back to our views. And then what we need to do is we need to actually make sure that we pass in our context dictionary. So that's something I wanted to go through with you. So here we actually pass our context dictionary. So it will be form and form. And then we need to return the context dictionary here. So remember, we'd say context equals context. Just like so, and we're going to use that value and output and reference it here. Okay, so if we refresh now, there we go. So now we can actually create a task. So what's going to happen now is once we have created a task and it was successful, it's going to return a HTTP response saying your task was created. Then we can check now in our admin page if the task was actually created. So to do that, so I'm going to create a task here. I'm going to say do chores at home must be done by 11 a.m. Okay, then I'm going to say submit, and based on our logic, we are going to see a blank page HTTP response saying your task was created. So let's give that a shot. There we go, your task was created. Now we want to actually validate and check this if it actually worked. So technically, we've just created a new record. So if we go to our admin page, and if we were to log in with our super user, go to tasks. Yep, there we go. We have that object. So do chores at home must be done by 11 a.m. So we have successfully created a record using CRUD, and it's been sent to our database. Okay, so that is how we would go ahead and create a record in Django. So let's go back to our home page. All right, and we want to actually read our record. Okay, so you guys have already learned about reading records. Okay, so it's very straightforward. So we're going to just repeat what we've done before, but instead of actually seeing it on the homepage, we want to create a specific view for reading tasks. So I'm going to make it very simple. So let's just clear our minds here and close everything. Okay, and let's focus. So we're going to now create a HTML template just to read a task. Okay, so we have create task, and now I'm just going to create a page that is called, let's say, view tasks.html. So this will show all of our tasks. Okay, and what we can do, we can, of course, we can copy over some logic. So if we go to our create task page, like here, we can just borrow a little bit of our code. So we are just going to take this here. Okay, our base HTML. So here I'm just going to say So let's say CRUD read all tasks. And the read tasks here, I'm just going to replace this here as well. So here I'm going to say, CRUD create a task. Just like that. Okay. So there we have it. Now I just want us to connect this view tasks. So it's a lot of what we've done before. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm just going to say here. So I'm going to just put a comment here. So remember, it's always good to put comments in your code. So here I'm going to put CRUD operations. So here we have create task. And now I'm going to have read task. Okay, so there we go. So basically, we are going to manipulate our database again. So here I'm going to say, what is it called? View tasks. Yep. So I like to model our route here was our HTML template name. And then I can just say views.view. It'll be view task. Yeah, I'm going to do it like that. So view tasks. Let's keep it like that. Okay. Then I need to create the view, which we can just do here. Okay. So I'm going to say, view tasks. And a fancy thing that we can do here. This is from Python. We can just put in pass. Okay. So this is just going to make sure pretty much that our code doesn't crash or have an error. So this is a very handy feature when we just want to pause and work on something else at the moment. Okay. So this is where we will read our tasks. So I just want to put a comment here saying create a task. And read a task. Okay. So there we have it. So we have our create a task view and now our read a task. So this will be view tasks. Okay. So this is going to be very straightforward. We are simply just going to go ahead and create a sort of a query here. So I'm going to say query data all, and I'm going to set it to task.objects.all. So I want to retrieve and read all the tasks. Okay, then I need to simply go ahead and sort of create a context dictionary. Okay, so I'm going to pass query data all. So I can copy this here. All right. And what I can do is remove this pass here. And I need to put in the query data all here as the value. You can give this any name that you want. And the context is being passed here. And what I can do actually to make this make more sense, I can say this is called task. Or tasks would make more sense. That and here I'd have tasks just like that. Okay, so there we have it. So we have our value here, tasks, and our key, which is going to be the reference here, which is going to be tasks. Okay, so we can now go to view tasks and we can simply just go ahead and create our for loop with our tag. So for, and we can say here task in tasks. Okay, and then we need to just put our end for, which I always put first. Okay, that's perfect. And then our attributes. So we need to reference our attributes. So what do we have? We only have two. So we can check it here. We have title and content. And we want to just render this out. So if we look at our context here, our key is tasks and our value is tasks. So we're going to reference by our key. All right. So for task in tasks, here's our key here, which we reference here. And the value which is going to take in is going to be based on all the objects in our task model. So we've only created one, so we should only see one. So we can go ahead here and just render it out. So here I'm going to say task.title and here task.content. Okay, now I can just actually I can put it here. I just want to add some breakpoints here just to make it a bit clearer. Okay, like so. Okay, there we go. And indent it a bit nicely. and put a breakpoint at the top. Okay, so this page here is going to read all our tasks. So we're going to view our tasks here. And on create task.html, we're going to create our task. So we can simply just close this up here. Okay, and open our view again. So this is perfect. So it's good to always just double check your code, make sure everything's running as it should. Okay, double check our URLs. This is good. Good view task. Okay, so let's go ahead and check this out. Ah, so we forgot to add our comma. Okay, then we need to, let's just check here. Line 25, okay. View, ah, so just double check your, I just made it a capital, that's perfect. So I accidentally put a capital, so a lowercase is fine. So that should run, okay, that's good. So let's just go back and check everything. Ah, we just need to change our HTML here to views.task. Let's double check the template there, view, and then tasks. Okay, so just double check that and the URL, view tasks, that's good. So if we go back and we refresh and we check our view tasks here, so just double check that route there. We can see here that we can read all of our tasks. Okay, so we can see this is working perfectly. So this will be reading all tasks. And if we were to go to create task, we can go ahead and create one. And I'm going to just say here, complete data. I'm just going to say here, data entry must be finished by Friday. And we can say submit. Perfect. We can now go to our read, what's it called? View tasks. And there we go. Okay, so we can see the next set has been entered. So I just want to clean that up a little bit. So what we can do is we can just simply above here, put a breakpoint. And let's add that. Let's see if that, yeah, that does help a little bit. So it looks a bit cleaner. So there we go. So our first object and our second object. Now, we have noticed that we are, we can see here, we're not having a redirect. We are just returning a HTTP response. So what we want to do is we want to create a task and redirect to our view tasks page. Okay, so we can see when we create. So I just want to take this out and I want to say return redirect. And simply I'm just going to redirect to our view tasks page. So I can put that route in here like that, right? And for this to actually work, this redirect, we will need to just add a third parameter here to our URL path. So we have our route, our views, and we need to add a third one, which is going to be name. And we need to say, we need to explicitly say here, so I like to use double quotes, what we're going to be routing to, what we're redirecting to. So we are going to redirect to view tasks, okay? So we can see it here. And we just need to put it in the name there in order for this URL, for this redirect to actually work. So if we go back here and let's actually create a task. So I'm going to go ahead and create a task. So a record here. So I'm here, I'm going to say prepare for a test. Here I'm going to say the content study 5 hours a day. Okay, there we go. So there's our title and our content. So we can go ahead now and submit this. So as we've seen here, we should be technically, we should redirect to view tasks upon completion and submission of this form here. So just go ahead and do that. So let's say submit. And there we go. So we can now see our latest object here that was created. We were redirected to view tasks. And this is effectively how we would go about reading of course, all of our objects in the task model. Okay, so you've now learned how to create a task and you've also learned how to read a task. Okay, so this is halfway in CRUD. So well done if you got to this point. So you are halfway there. So next up would be update and delete. So yeah, that's it. So I hope it made sense and that you liked it. So you're now able to create and read data. All right. So that's it.